Hello and welcome back. In this live video here on Amazon Live, I want to show you some simple but powerful activities that will really help with math fact fluency. So I'm talking about math facts, adding, subtraction, addition, multiplication. And this is really important. And I think a lot of parents can overlook this because when we talk about math struggles and, you know, kids having a hard time with math, there's really three reasons why. The most serious, of course, is conceptual. They don't understand the concepts of what's going on. So that, you know, requires a bit more steps. It's not as easy to fix, but the other two are pretty easy. The other one is carelessness, not lining numbers up correctly. So that could be a simple fix with graph paper or working on, you know, writing numbers a little neater, things like that. And the last one of the third is computational, just making mistakes when it comes to the actual equations, math, just adding, subtracting, multiplication, division, all of that. So those are the three most common errors: conceptual, carelessness, computational. So in learning math facts, reviewing them, really having them down, that they're by rote memory, this is really going to help with that part of it. And they start gaining confidence as they're getting more and more problems right, and it just trickles down to all the other areas. So I want to share with you some, this is my one electronic thing, and then the rest are non-electronic, how to, you know, review and practice those math facts. Now, I'm a homeschooling mom of six children, and we use the Robinson curriculum, which is pretty unique. It is minimalistic, but extremely effective. It covers the three R's: reading, writing, and arithmetic, and all the other subjects get really covered through this book list. But the math portion, I think, is unique because there's no busy work. Mom doesn't have to sit down there and teach all these lessons, so it's great for moms of many. They just have to learn their math facts before they start a fifth grade textbook, Saxon 5-4. This is the first textbook that they will start. And prior to this, all they need to know is their math facts. Now, obviously, they need to know how to write their numbers, some number recognition, obviously counting, things like that. But they can just work on learning the math facts themselves and then start 5-4 in a self-taught format. As long as they can read and they have their math facts memorized, they can read the lesson, see the examples, work the problems, correct themselves, and then fix their mistakes. So again, really the foundation they need is just memorizing their math facts, and then they can start with a fifth grade textbook. So imagine how ahead of their peers they will be taking this sort of shortcut approach of no busy work. So, you know, they're learning their math facts, and there's different ways that you could do that, you know, just flashcards, things like that. But let's say maybe they just need a little bit more review. These are some things they can do on their own during their off time. This is a game here called Trifacta. Math facts equals math plus facts equals fun. So it's a triangle like this, and it has all these little cards, all these numbers. And so basically it's a four player game. They're trying to create these math fact families. So if they have a 10 here, they could have, you know, a 5 and a 5. So 5 plus 5 equals 10, or 10 minus 5 equals 5. So obviously it's just this whole math fact family. So this is a game that they can play on their own. They can play with their siblings. Believe it or not, they do have fun playing with this. So that is ages 6 and up, 2 to 4 players. Again, it's Trifacta. I got this off of Amazon. So this is really great for little kids. Now, here's the electronic thing I have here, Math Shark. And I like it because you can turn the sounds on and off, so you can make it silent. And it has addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. So you pick the operation, you can pick the level of difficulty, and if you want to just target maybe the 3 times tables, the 4 times tables, then you can pick that, you know, multiply, number 2, how hard. Do you want it to just go in the single digits? Do you want it to multiply the double digits? That's that part. And it even has here fractions, all this stuff. So this is really cool. I much prefer this than apps on phones or iPads. We don't do any of that here. My kids don't have any of those devices. So this is a way that's electronic. It catches their eye, like, oh, this is fun. You know, it's like a little game system for them, but all they can do is just work on their math facts. So that is this product here that I am highlighting, the Math Shark. Now, another option for parents that maybe have a little bit more time to sit with their kids, they want to do that, they want to go over some things, are these books. I also got these on Amazon. They're from a Well-Trained Mind Press, Addition Facts That Stick. So this is a program for 6 weeks that will go through systematically all the math facts in a way that makes sense, right? Like numbers that add up to 10, or less than 10, or the strategy of adding nines. You're adding 10, subtracting one, same thing with the eights, you're adding two, you know, all of that stuff. So that is, this is Subtraction Facts That Stick. This is an 8-week program. Then we have Division Facts. This is 10 weeks. And Multiplication Facts, this is another 10 weeks. So even if you took a whole year, you know, to memorize math facts, and you did it in this very slow and steady way, less than a year, they would have all their math facts memorized. So there's a lot of games in here. They come with all the worksheets and things and little games, but you know, with the addition, all you really need is just a deck of cards. There's so many things that you could do with this. For example, Go Fish. You know, you take out all the face cards, obviously, but let's say you're working on facts that add up to 10, and you have your deck of cards here, and you say, okay, I have a 6 here. What, 6 plus what equals 10? You know, 4. So I'd ask my partner, do you have a 4? And if they do, they have to give it to me, and I can make a bit, oh, 6 plus 4, you know, 10. And if they say no, Go Fish, then I grab a couple more from this stack, and then it's their turn. So it's a lot of games like that in these books. Again, all you need is a deck of cards, and they have a lot of the board games. There's bingo, just lots of different things. And if you have a child who's just kind of struggling with maybe division, you can just use the division one because it's a 2-in-1, right? It's covering multiplication and division the way that it's taught here. So you can kind of just take a shortcut there. Same thing with the subtraction. Kind of, if they're struggling with addition, you could try the subtract. It's kind of the same, right? So that's, and there's also these little chips that help too, that for the game pieces that you could use. But this is the one that you'd have to sit down and be more involved, you know, the books. But maybe if you only have one child and they're 5, 6, you have all the time to just sit there and memorize their math facts, help them play these games, that's the way to go. But if you have an older child and they're struggling, you need to just catch them up real quickly. Maybe Math Shark, games like this, or I'm going to tell you right now just my favorite way to teach math facts, to review math facts, using flashcards and an abacus. That's it. So for example, here's an abacus. Let's see if I have one highlighted here. I find this to just be the most no-nonsense approach. So what you would do is obviously teach them how to count, you know, go through, if it's a 5-year-old, just counting to 10 and then going up to 20. Take your time, slow and steady wins the race, going all the way. But then once they can really count from 0 to 100, forwards and backwards, you're ready to move on. So then teach them how to count by 2s, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Maybe that's as much as you go on the first day. Take your time. They need to be able to count to 10 forwards and backwards. 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, etc. Record it every day. Write the date and say, okay, let's see how long it takes. You get a little timer and time them. Okay, this is going to make it fun for them. They want to beat their time. So you say, okay, let's see how fast you could do it on the first try. Let's see how fast you do it on the second try and the third try. And they will see that there is improvement. So once they can count to 2 by 2 solidly all the way to 100 forwards and backwards, then you can start bringing out the math facts. Now, with the Robinson curriculum, the RC purist way is just to mix up all the operations and have a child just drill the flashcards themselves. Give them a chunk and they look at it and say, okay, 20 divided by 2. If they know it, they put it on one pile. If they don't know it, they put it on the other pile. And then they keep going with the whole pile. At the end, they pick up the wrong pile and they do it again, a right pile and a wrong pile, until there's nothing in the wrong pile, right? Because they've repeated it so many times. So that's the RC Pierce way, all operations mixed in. So this is a little bit of a twist on that if that seems, whoa, too much, too overwhelming. Do you know what I talked about, counting by twos, and then take out all the math facts that have to do with twos. So I would first start to show them the concept of two times. So two times two is two times. So two times two is four, two times three is six. And they've been counting by twos, forwards and backwards, that this clicks. That just makes a lot of sense. After you do all the twos times tables and they've practiced for a while, as long as it takes, you know, that they can verbalize, just answer the problems, then you can transition to division. Okay, so six divided by two. I've given the number six, how many total? And then I'm dividing it into groups of two. So how many groups do I have? Okay, three. So then you can go through all the two division. And then you can bring out, these are the RC flashcards, which I love. They're nice and big, they're color coded, the different operations. And so this is gonna be a lot easier for them. Nine, take away two, they know to count backwards by two. Okay, same thing, two minus two, but then you mix it up with addition, nine plus two. So they're comfortable with skip counting by two. And of course you have the times tables, right? Two times two, two times 10, and they can visualize it. You know, two counting by twos, you know, five times, how much is that? This is gonna click for them a lot easier. And then of course also subtraction, seven minus two, they're going backwards. So you can still mix up all the flashcards, adding, subtraction, division, multiplication, after you explain it this way. Counting by twos, forwards and backwards, till they really have it down, showing them multiplication. So then you can go ahead and division. Now, if you have a child that is kind of behind and you're trying to catch them up, then I would just start with division. I would do the skip counting by two and then do the division, because again, it kind of both go hand in hand together. So showing them six divided by two is three, they'll know two times three is six, right? So if it's that situation, maybe just start with division first, because memorizing multiplication facts can get a little harder the older they are. So it just depends on their age and where they're at and what is the goal, right? What is the goal? That is also what you need to keep in mind. If it's to catch them up, or if you're laying the foundation from the very beginning and just learning these math facts to then start a textbook, you know, 5-4. So those are my tips for math fact fluency. Again, my favorite way, the way I find, is just no busy work, just cut to it, skip counting by twos, then show them the multiplication by twos, show them the division by twos, let them work on these flashcards by themselves with the twos, and then you would go on by threes, skip counting by threes, and then showing them the multiplication by threes, and then the divisions by three. But they need to have that skip counting by three down packed, you know, just rote memory. And then when you explain the concepts and you give them the flashcards, it's going to be a lot easier. And things like with the timer, they really help. And writing it down, their progress every day, that really will help. And you know, RC recommends kind of a little fun game. If they can beat their best time, they don't have to do it the next day. So maybe you wanna play with that once in a while as well. So that's it. And then you have trifecta, things that they could do on their own. Math Shark, maybe do a couple rounds of this a day. That's it, and then they will have their math facts down. That is the most important thing, foundational, I think, when it comes to math.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave, and I invite you to join my membership site, which is named after Ella Frances Lynch organization. This one's called the Modern League of Teacher Mothers, and I host their live Q&As, coffee chats. We have book clubs, read aloud selections for kids, as well as the special additional training workshops, private videos from me. And you can also have access to my 26 video course, Sustainable Homeschooling 101. And really all of it, the course and the membership site, focuses on content, no burnout zone, on being sustainable sticking to what is essential, what is important, work habits, study habits, morals, the three R's, simplicity at its best, right? All of that in this membership site. So I hope you will join me there, and I'll see you soon. Bye.